नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज कॉर्पोरेट फाइनेंस। व्हाट इज कॉर्पोरेट फाइनेंस? कॉर्पोरेट फाइनेंस डील्स विद द कैपिटल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ए कॉर्पोरेशन, इंक्लूडिंग इट्स फंडिंग एंड द एक्शन दैट मैनेजमेंट टेक्स टू इंक्रीज द वैल्यू ऑफ द कंपनी। कॉर्पोरेट फाइनेंस आल्सो इंक्लूड्स द टूल्स एंड एनालाइज यूटिलाइज टू प्रायोरिटाइज एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूट फाइनेंशियल रिसोर्सेज। The ultimate purpose of corporate finance is to maximize the value of a business through planning and implementation of resources while balancing risk and profitability. Three important activities that govern corporate finance: investment and capital budgeting. Investing and capital budgeting includes planning where to place the company long-term capital assets in order to guarantee the highest risk-adjusted returns. The mainly consists of deciding whether or not to pursue an edge investment opportunity and is accomplished through extensive financial analysis. By using financial accounting tools, a company identifies capital expenditures, estimates cash flow from proposed capital projects, compares planned investment with project income, and decides which projects to include in the capital budget. Financial modeling is used to estimate the economic impact of an investment opportunity and compare alternative projects. An analyst with often used to internal rate of return in conjunction with next present value to compare projects and pick the optimal one. Capital financing. The cover activity or the core activity includes decisions on how to optimally finance the capital investments through the business equity debt or a mix of both. Long-term funding for major capital expenditures or investment may be obtained from selling company stocks or issuing debt securities in the market through investment banks. Balancing the two sources of funding should be closely managed because having too much debt may increase the risk of default in payment, while depending too heavily on equity may dilute earnings and value for original investor. Ultimately, it's the job of corporate finance professionals to optimize the company capital structure by lowering its weighted average cost of capital WACC as much as possible. Dividends and return of capital. This activity requires corporate managers to decide whether to retain a business access earning for future investment and operational requirements or to distribute the earnings to shareholders in the form of dividends or share buybacks. Retained earnings that are not distributed back to shareholders may be used to fund a business expansion. This can often be the best source of funds as it does not incur additional debts nor dilute the value of equity by issuing more shares. At the end of the day, if corporate managers believe that that can earn a rate of return on a capital investment that's greater than the company cost of capital, they should pursue. Otherwise, they should return excess capital to shareholders via dividend or share buybacks. Thank you so much.